Scarborough journalist announcing secret trial for Nnamdi Kanu. These people, they know they shame at all. They know they shame. Sometimes I wonder why the court is bent on wasting everyone's time. We all know the outcome of the trial already. You understand? Why not just go ahead and find him guilty and let's see what happened next? Let's see if these people in power can kill him and eat his meat. We all understand that all this joining of the courts, adjoining of the court cases they have planned. You understand? We are tired of this kangaroo trial that is leading nowhere, but the only made the court to become a mockery of itself. This is going to be a very big shame. Anyway, let's see how this the outcome of this. The Chief Judge of the Federal High Court, FHC in Abuja, Justice John Toko, has released a new practice direction for the trial of treason suit before the court, such as the case of Nnamdi Kanu. Politics Nigeria reports that Justice Toso stated that the new practice direction is in the exercise of his constitutional powers as contained in section 254 of the Constitution of Nigeria 1999 as amended. Under the new arrangement, the court said media coverage of proceedings is strictly prohibited except as many may be directed by the court. Kanu is expected to appear in court tomorrow, Friday, in continuation of his trial. His outlawed Indigenous People of Biafra IPOB organization is agitating for the secession of a swath of the Southeast that is home to the Igbo ethnic group. The idea of Biafra first started almost six decades ago after a pogrom unleashed against people of Igbo descent in northern Nigeria. Emeka Odumegwu Ojukwu, the military governor of eastern Nigeria, pulled the predominantly Igbo region out of the country. He survived all of 30 months, and by the time the war ended in 1970, more than a million people had died. So guys, you've all heard it now. All these are just their plans to do what they want to do. But they should understand that it's either two things will happen. Either they jail Nnamdi Kanu or they sentence him to, I don't just want to say that because it's not words anyone can hear. The only thing I have to say here is that the federal government have to be very careful, because the world is watching this Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's case. If any mistake, they are not going to find it easy. Now they are banning journalists, whatever. This has been their game plan all this while. And they know what they are doing. That is the reason why they are always restricting people to the courtroom. Now this Nigerian government, the matter is just tired. It's just tiring. You understand? It's just tiring. What are all this? You want to crucify someone who is agitating for freedom, but those who are killing people every now and then are free people in this country. Tomorrow, after killing people, they will lay down their arms and they will tell you that they are repentant. Boko Haram or bandits, and Nigerian government will give them good life. What is going on here? Some persons are saying that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is causing calamity in the Southeast, this and this and that. They should not forget that what is going on in the Southeast is being stage managed. That is the truth. Just to make sure that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is being frustrated and for them to have their way. Because the next thing Buhari will say again, that Mazina the Kanu, you know, is not fit to be released because he continued to misbehave. See, the world is hearing what is happening. The world is seeing everything. Even with the sit-at-home that is going on now in the Southeast, several times the IPOB member, they have released a press, numerous times they released a press release asking people to go to their normal businesses and all that. So I don't know what, you know, they want them to do. They even asked the federal government that they are ready for dialogue, if they are ready and all that. This just to make sure that they themselves, they want peace. Okay. So the way Nigerian government is going about this whole thing is going to escalate the situation on ground. So they have to be guided to avoid more calamities that we already have in Nigeria. You understand? This is not just the issue of Southeast or whatever, because when it comes, it's going to affect everybody. That is the gospel truth. When the rain will start, it will affect, it will touch everybody. So they have to be very careful the way they deal with, you know, agitators. And Nigerians have been telling them, release this man unconditionally. Let peace reign. At least, and they talk say step by step. Now, so they say they do matter. You don't make peace with war, but you make peace with love. Why can't you just extend that love to the Southeasterners? You understand? Are we going to say that what they are talking about is just blah, blah, blah? They are not making sense. Is there nothing like marginalization in their region? Even when we are hearing, seeing all that is happening, that they cannot rule Nigeria. And the question is why? And these are the things that generated all these agitations here and there. Anyway, let's see how tomorrow we fold, because tomorrow is the D-Day. Nigerians are watching, the world is watching, the federal government, their next step and their decision concerning this Mazina Nnamdi Kanu's case. I'm dropping it here. Guys, kindly share your thoughts with us below the comment section. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel, please, if you have not. Thank you very much once again. God bless you. Bye for now.